In 2009, the Jonas Brothers sold concert tickets, albums, and merchandise to the tune of more than $100 million.
That's like a dream come true.
22-year-old Kevin, 20-year-old Joe, and 17-year-old Nick defied the critics with their tight music skills and wholesome image. They also redefined the meaning of boy band.
They're definitely unlikely rock stars.
They're the real deal. They've got the talent, and they back it up with the blood, sweat, and hard work.
They've conquered a lot of crazy demographics that they didn't think was possible in the beginning.
They defy the convention of what people assume rock and roll a rock star as.
I enjoy long walks on the beach.
The Jonas Brothers were raised in a religious home, far removed from the sex and drugs of rock and roll. Their parents, Denise Miller and Kevin Jonas Sr., were Christian musicians who met at Bible College in 1985.
We did not actually date. We became really great friends, but by Christmas it was really evident to both of our hearts that we would like to spend the rest of our lives together. And right back from Christmas vacation, he proposed.
The couple married a year later and settled in New Jersey, where Kevin worked as a youth pastor. In November 1987, they welcomed their first son.
I was 21 when I gave birth to Kevin, who is my oldest. He was kind of unexpected, but joyfully received. And he was the most outgoing little thing, and curly little head, and he talked nonstop.
The three soon relocated to Casa Grande, Arizona, where they were joined by another baby boy on August 15th, 1989.
Jess was always quiet when he was little, and because I think he was in Kevin's shadow a lot. Kevin did all the talking, so he didn't really need to say anything.
Meanwhile, Pastor Jonas took the family on the road.
We traveled in a 15-passenger van with a trailer hauling behind us. We would travel for hours, and I would get to a location, and I would have to perform with my husband and this group. And the kids would go every night to a different group of kids. And I look back, and I think, oh my goodness, how did I do that?
In September 1992, the newest Jonas brother, Nicholas Jerry, was born in Dallas, Texas.
Nicholas, my number three, was our musical world genius from the time he could do anything.
I knew he had something that was different.
He could recognize musical instruments and tones.
We would listen to everything from country to pop to rock to classic. And he would call out the instruments, you know, drums, guitar, bass, oboe, French horn, violin.
And had perfect pitch. It was shocking to us.
The family kept singing and moving. Then in 1996, settled in a New Jersey suburb just outside of New York City.
Pastor Kevin led worship at Christ for the Nations and has a beautiful voice. The whole family was always involved.
It was a wonderful time. I think it helped them, you know, to understand how to communicate with people and learn how to be in a band.
Kevin will be one of the guitar players. Nick and Joe would be singers.
It's kind of where I branched out a little bit, because they always have Christmas plays and things like that at churches. And so that really helped me build up the courage to be able to go out for different roles. Growing up in the church, singing in the church was great. Good training for what I'm doing now.
It was really nice to be able to be on stage every Sunday and I can remember the moment. I looked at myself saying, like, I want to do this forever.
6-year-old Nicholas performed anywhere he had a captive audience, including his mom's favorite beauty parlor, where a customer took notice.
She was getting her hair done, and I walked in and just started singing.
And there's a woman sitting there, and she flips around the chair and said, you need to take him to see a manager. She said, my son is a child on Broadway, and I know who you need to go see. And she wrote her name down. We said, okay. So we went to see this woman, this manager, Shirley Grant.
Nick came with his mom and dad. He said, I want an agent. I want to do Broadway. And he sang for us.
I didn't know anything other than, like, pop music songs. And she wanted me to be able to sing some Broadway tunes. So I had to learn, like, 10 Broadway songs.
Shirley Grant was impressed.
We gave him a contract. And the other two boys, I guess, got a little jealous. They said, I want to do this, too.
Me and Kevin, we were sitting in the waiting room, and they were like, oh, you have brothers, well, let's see them. So we came in, they asked us to read something for them, and they signed all of us.
The grief and the fear was so overwhelming.